When I saw on the list that I was following Emily, I was distraught because like, I love Emily, she's an amazing speaker, and then you get me. So enjoy. So I'm going to be looking very, very quickly at three ways that I use music in history. It's going to be very, very quick because I've admitted to myself that I needed more time and I didn't ask for more time. So I've put everything on my Google Drive and there's a link on my pinned tweet. So if I run out of time, which I probably will, just go there and everything is there. Examples, resources, everything that I should have spoken about but will not give myself enough time to do. So first technique that I use music for is one that we've probably all used at one point or another. I just develop it a little bit more. So the hook is the classic, playing a song as students enter the classroom to introduce a topic or ask them to think about what they might be learning about based on that song. Lots and lots of different examples, a ton of examples on Active History. There are so many on a Spotify list as well. I take that one step further by giving students just a little printout of the lyrics that I want them to look at in the song that we are analysing, and then revisiting and reviewing that later on, perhaps at the end of a lesson or the following lesson, so that they can use what we've learned to then interpret those lyrics and think about what they've learned and how that applies. So for example, I've used one before, it's called All For You, Sophia by Franz Ferdinand, and it's about the assassination of Franz Ferdinand. There are key terms in there like Gavrilo Princip, Apple Key, Franz Ferdinand, that will not make sense if you don't know about those events. But those events, that doesn't make sense either, but will at the end of the topic, so students can apply their knowledge to this song using what you have shown to them. The second technique that I would use is a mnemonic song. So I generally will give students an existing song, the structure, the lyrics, the melody, ask them to go away and then adapt the lyrics to create their own mnemonic device for revision. So my example here, I was looking at Britain, Health and the People for AQA history and gave my students a song called We Need Medicine because I thought it fit quite well and asked them to adapt it to help them to revise the significance of Hippocrates and Galen. So they were able to come up with some fantastic examples and just change the words to help them to remember all of these facts and things that they wanted to know. And that leads on quite well into my third technique that I'll share with you very, very quickly, analysis of songs. So this involves giving students a song, some contextual knowledge, and asking them to figure out what it means. I've used this more recently with an album called The Railway People, which was written after a visit to Auschwitz and at the end of a study on the Holocaust with Year 9. So students have looked at this song, they've got contextual knowledge from studying the Holocaust, and I've given them contextual knowledge about the artist as well, so they can start to think about this artist, his background, his experiences, and how that informs what he is writing about. And all of that comes together to help them to analyse and interpret this song and figure out how it applies to their learning. So they just need to consider all of these questions, and then that helps them to figure out what this song is all about in terms of their learning. Now that can link on quite well from the mnemonic because I've used that, what was that? I have used that before by asking students to swap songs and then analyse each other's and interpret each other's songs so they can see, has your partner followed the success criteria? Have they included all of the key facts that they need? I also find this is quite useful to do prior to introducing historical interpretations to students, where we ask students to think about why an author might say what they are saying or have the opinion that they have, it links into why this songwriter might be writing about this experience. Everything that I've talked about is in a lot more detail with a lot less rambling on the Google Drive, so please do check that. And if you have any great music and history ideas, please let me know because I would love to steal them. And that's it. Thank you.